Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 17.2 Beta 3 and iOS 17.1.1 have both been out for a little while now. We'll talk about the experience since most of us have been using one of those versions. We'll also talk about your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where at the time of this video there's 18,000 votes and 196 comments. I've used all of those comments, read all of them to determine what the overall experience is like. We'll talk about features, some Apple news, things you should know, as well as what you can expect as far as the next updates, when they should release as well. Now, the first thing is there's an app for iOS, or rather Apple Watch, called WatchTube. It seems that it's shutting down, unfortunately. So you'll see here on the Apple Watch, if I go into the app WatchTube, there's actually a message here saying that they're working the best they can to get it working, but right now the servers have been taken offline. Now, I don't know if this is against YouTube's policy, maybe that's part of the problem, or something else, but they haven't really specified. But they have used some of my images in the past, and it's something that apparently a lot of people enjoyed. So be sure to check back and see if that's working, or let me know if you've heard anything else about that as well. Now, Apple had quite a few Black Friday deals, and many are still live, not necessarily on Apple's website, but also other services, things like Amazon, other websites as well. Best Buy has a lot of deals. And if we go to the store here, we'll go to Apple Store. You don't see a whole lot of updates here, but there are quite a few deals throughout, such as on Amazon, there's Apple Watch at a big discount, just about every version of Apple Watch. And I'll link some of those in the description if you want to check them out. Now, we've talked quite a bit about Apple bringing RCS messaging to iOS next year. I wanted to mention a couple other things, as many don't necessarily seem to understand that it's basically just an updated version of SMS and MMS. So if you're using that, it brings additional features. MacRumors actually has a really nice breakdown of all the different rich communication services. That's what RCS stands for, what it actually does, and things it supports, such as audio messages and cross-platform emoji reactions. That's built in and will work across iMessage and then Android and other things. So it's not really anything that's going to change the way iMessage works. It rather just lets it interact a little bit differently. Maybe they'll add encryption and more, but I'll link that in the description if you want to check that out, with all of the different things it can do, with improved group chats and much more, which will be better for iMessage users as well. That's a big deal in the United States. When Android joins iMessage, it sometimes can mess that up. Now, due to Thanksgiving in the United States, we haven't had a lot of updates this week. There's been a few app updates, but Apple typically takes the week off and they'll resume next week. You can actually see this in the feedback app. So if we go into recent activity, you can see it here where they'll be back in the office on November 27th. So after that point is when we should expect new updates. We'll talk about that in a moment. Now, I wanted to talk about some new features, and the first one has to do with a new splash screen. If you go into Apple Fitness, you may see this pop up. I saw this. I had my friend Brom send this along who saw this. You'll see it says your 6-week restart. Get back into fitness or get inspired to try something new with these specially curated workouts. So if you've been wanting to try it out, they're getting you started off easily, and this is available now if you're using the Fitness app. So that's something that popped up for me. Now, I think now that we've had iOS 17.2 in beta for a while, I wanted to go over some of the features quickly just to refresh your memory. The major one, of course, is the Journal app, and this is something I probably haven't used as much as I should. And let me know if you're using it. I don't really trust it yet, as I want to make sure that all of my entries stay there, so I'll probably wait until the final release to use it regularly. But I did used to use Day 1 quite a bit, and I find it to be something that's helpful to journal every once in a while, if not daily. So let me know if you're using that in the comments below. Now, also, of course, with music, we've got favorited playlists that are there now, finally. So if we go into our library, go to our playlists, we've got our favorite songs playlists. And then, of course, we can collaborate on these playlists now as well. So if we have maybe this one that I created, you can collaborate here. You'll see I have some collaboration going on. And it also tells you who's added each song when they've added one. You can see that here. So if you add different songs, it will let you know who's added that. Additionally, there's some new clock widgets and weather widgets. So this is one here for weather. If we go over and add a widget, you can see in the different weather widgets, here's the main ones we've had, but here's some new ones with additional details, as that one's called. We've got daily forecast, as well as sunrise and sunset. Also, if we go up to clock here, there's another one. So let's scroll up. We'll go to clock. And within clock, we have a new digital clock. So we've got many of the normal ones we've had, but then also that digital clock as well. So that's really nice. If you wanted to use that, that's available in iOS 17.2. Also, if we go back, and this one's questionable, if we go to our lock screen, if we customize our weather widget, Apple has made some changes to the wind widget, but we don't know if that's going to be in the final version. They sort of changed it completely and then brought back the original version. So that's something that I actually liked, the one they changed it to. We don't know if they're going to change that back. I'm using the Lumi widget here from the Lumi app, if you're curious about what that one is. Now, as far as the action button, Apple has updated that as well. I've talked about that in the iOS update, but again, if we go into settings, then we go to action button, we now have the option for translate. That wasn't in the original version, and it has a really nice animation. So if you want to translate, it's listening, and then you can see it there. So that's something that's really helpful. If you want to use translate, you can now do that. I typically just leave it on flashlight though, but let me know what you use the action button for. Of course, we have contact key verification finally for iMessage. That can be found in iMessage or within your settings. Within your Apple ID settings, you'll see contact key verification, and then you can enable this to verify who you're speaking with. They can set up the same thing and sort of verify that you are who you say you are. So that's something I'll be using later, as you actually have to have all of your different devices updated, and I don't want everything on a beta. So you'll see as we wait just a moment here, it'll pop up. Give it a moment there, and you have to update all of your devices. So I'm going to wait just a bit to do that. Now we've had stickers and messages as well, and they've added a new one where we can add a sticker to reply. We'll just add this one here, and it replies to the previous update of whoever's messaged you. So that's something they've changed. They've also added a couple new options. So if we go into AirPlay under our settings, so let's get out of this. Under general, and then if we go under AirPlay and handoff, you'll see we have AirPlay receiver. So if you have that enabled, you can allow AirPlay for everyone, require a password. That's something that you can use later where you can stream or share content from Apple Vision Pro to your iPhone. And speaking of Apple Vision Pro, there's also a new option for your camera. Within your camera, if you weren't aware of this, if you have a 15 Pro or 14 Pro, you'd need a LiDAR sensor for this to work. But within here, if we go to video, you'll see there we have options here. It's a little buggy, but we have a Vision Pro option. So we can enable that to get spatial video and then use that on the Vision Pro later. So it'll actually capture depth information. And if we want to capture that, we can. That again is in your settings. We'll go back, go to our camera settings, and under our format options in camera, we have the option for spatial video for Apple Vision Pro. So I just wanted to reiterate some of these, as many people either forgot them or didn't watch the initial video as well. Additionally, focus filters have been updated. So if we go back and within a new focus, if we add a filter, we have the option for music now. So they've updated this with listening history. So you can use listening history or choose if music played will influence recommendations and mixes appear in recently played or be shown to others on Apple Music. If we go into a contact card, so we'll go into one I have here, go under monogram, then tap your name at the top, slide over, there's a new rainbow color option. So that's something very minor they've updated. And also if we go into books, this has been updated as well. So within books, if we go into our options here, so we'll go options, themes and settings. Under themes and settings, we have the page turn option. We now have the option for fast fade. So that's something we can change where fast fade will just let us fade between different pages instead of using the page turn. I still personally prefer the original page turn sort of curl look. That was something that they originally had where you could sort of turn the page like it was real. Now I went over all those features just to remind you what's in iOS 17.2, as we often forget, and I haven't covered them all together as those were features that were spread over beta 1, beta 2, and iOS 17.2 beta 3. With iOS 17.2 though, we can expect beta 4 very soon to bring more refinement to things such as the journal app, more bug fixes, maybe some new features we weren't expecting. And we can expect that update hopefully sometime this week. Based on what we had last year, we actually had iOS 16.2 beta 4 that released on December 1st. Now that would be the following week, but I think it should be sometime this week, along with iOS 17.1.2. We know that's in testing according to Mac Rumors and others. Now they're actually seeing it in logs. iOS 17.1.2 could be expected as soon as this week as well. Last year, iOS 16.1.2 released on November 30th, and then beta 4 was after that. So maybe we'll see it on Tuesday or Wednesday with a release of iOS 17.2 beta 4 later in the week. Hopefully that's what we see. So we could get a bunch of different updates and we'll be very close to the final basically version of iOS 17.2 releasing to the public, and then nothing else for the rest of the year except for maybe one beta update. So we can expect the final release of iOS 17.2 probably within the second week of December, like we had last year. Then we'll have a 17.3 beta, and then no updates typically until maybe the second or third week of January. That's typically what Apple does. Also, iOS 17.1 is no longer being signed, so you can only downgrade to iOS 17.1.1. So I would expect iOS 17.1.2 very soon. Now, iOS 17.1.1 for the average user seems to be okay. However, I'm hearing more and more bugs as time goes on. That's pretty typical as people notice things as they've used it more or more people install it. But in general, the main thing I'm hearing is that notifications aren't working properly. Sometimes they just don't actually show up, or they're just not dinging the phone so you know that you've been notified by something. This could be because a focus mode is enabled, but most of the time it seems that people are just not getting their notifications with certain apps. Also, I've heard of people saying they have frame rate drops, so if maybe they have a ProMotion display, they're noticing maybe it's a little laggy, or maybe they don't have ProMotion, but still it's a little slow. Also, there's that Wi-Fi issue still that Apple's basically confirmed and said it will be fixed in iOS 17.2. I'm hearing more and more about typing lag, so if you're on a website and you're just going to maybe Apple, they're saying it's lagging unexpectedly for no reason, so that's a little odd. Also, sometimes these ones are more major where it's not charging in certain cars such as GM, Lincoln, and others. And also there's charging issues with just in general, plug it in some older phones and it won't charge without rebooting the phone. So a lot of little issues that Apple definitely needs to fix that should be fixed already. Hopefully they take that seriously. And if you're having issues and you're on a beta, make sure you report it in feedback. As far as iOS 17.2 beta 3, well, I've been running that full time on my 15 Pro Max since it released. And for the most part, it's been okay, but I still have a few issues here and there. For example, that wallpaper issue where it's vibrant here when I'm on the lock screen or the notifications, then I swipe up and it sort of dims. I have that until I reboot, reset the wallpaper, then sometimes it works. Other things I have that are more serious are cellular data issues, where it just drops or Wi-Fi drops, and that seems to be a known issue, but I have constant issues where sometimes it just goes away and then comes back, and that shouldn't be the behavior of it for any reason. So I have different routers at different locations, and it does it with all of them. So there's definitely an issue there that Apple needs to address. The notification bug is ever present, which has been since iOS 16, it seems, where it just sort of jumps in from time to time. And then also notifications aren't showing up for some as well. So lots of little issues. The camera isn't really causing too many issues. It's not overheating. Some people are having that, but I'm not having that. In general, it's been okay, but there's occasional issues. So definitely some odd things going on. As far as the camera, I've been using it readily. It seems to be pretty good. In fact, I recorded the iPhone 15 Pro video with it. If you haven't seen that, for 2 months later, the good and bad, I recorded it with the 15 Pro Max. It did a great job, and I really had no issues with it. So if you haven't checked that out, the camera looks pretty good. Some of the images I took afterward look great. I don't think they're making any improvements, whether that's to the 14 Pro Max or 15 Pro Max, any of those, but I think it looks pretty good overall. Now, as far as the overall performance and heat of the phone, well, the performance has been good, other than people having lag on certain phones. I have had no issues as far as that goes. I've seen it nice and smooth, no issues. Scrolling, opening music, opening applications just seem to be nice and smooth in general. However, it hasn't gotten hot like some people have said either. So the overall temperature is nice and cool, and I'll just show you a quick comparison as many have continued to ask to see that. So here's a 14 Pro Max on the same version and a 15 Pro Max. Let's take a look. So on the 15 Pro Max, we have about 84.5 degrees Fahrenheit, which isn't warm at all. Basically, that's just from me holding it. And on the 14 Pro Max, about the same, 84.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Again, in Celsius, about 29 degrees Celsius, and on the 14 Pro Max, about the same, 29 degrees Celsius or so. So about the same, nice and cool, no issues there. And it seems to be staying nice and cool. Now, granted, I don't play a lot of games on here or anything, but in general, unless it's charging, and that's one thing I did test in my car this past week, Apple said it was fixed for BMWs, at least with the latest update. On iOS 17.2 beta 3 in my Audi, this got incredibly hot using the wireless charger. So I'm not going to use that until they actually fix it, because it's so hot you can barely touch it. So that's not good for the phone. If it's warm, it's okay, but not that hot. Now, as far as the battery life, let's take a look at that. We'll go into settings, general, and take a look at the cycle count. You'll see the current cycle count is 52. So basically just counting up as we would expect using it regularly. And if we go into battery life, battery health and charging, we're at 100% currently. And if we take a look at the battery life over the last few days, yesterday I had 2 hours and 27 minutes of screen active time, 3 hours and 57 minutes of screen idle time, used about 60% of the battery. That's not really that great. And then today I had 2 hours and 29 minutes of screen active time. Now I use this for the phone, or I use this for the camera on the phone rather, when I was recording the iPhone 15 video. So this is going to use a lot more power when you're recording 4K 60. The day before, I used about 75% of my battery and only had 3 hours and 14 minutes of screen active time, 5 hours and 17 minutes of screen idle time. So battery life overall hasn't been great. I haven't been using it a ton, but it's getting me through the day mostly. Sometimes I have to charge it depending on what I'm doing. I expect much better battery life than this, but if you're using something like Maps with Apple CarPlay and it's not plugged in or anything, you're going to use a lot of power. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 17.2 beta 3, well, if you haven't already, I'd probably just wait until this coming week when we expect it to release again with beta 4. As far as iOS 17.1.1, I would update to that just for the stability and security issues, especially if you have a BMW as well. That should be fixed as far as the wireless charger making it really hot and some other bug fixes as well. Hopefully we'll get an iOS 17.1.2 very soon with some more bug fixes that fix all of those little issues we're having and major issues with Wi-Fi and cellular. Now let's take a look at what you had to say. Now, depending on who you ask, the overall experience varies greatly. So I wanted to give you a couple examples. HotBZ76 says iOS 17.1.1 on iPhone 13 Pro Max. This has to be the worst iOS update for me since I've used an iPhone, and that's from 2007 when the first one came out. Battery life is atrocious. I used to be able to get a day and a half, and now I'm charging daily and I don't game or do social media, just texting and YouTube. I'm literally seeing the percentage drop while using my phone. And I also got a bug where my APP2 doesn't connect, AirPods Pro 2 doesn't connect when I take them out of the case. I always have to go and turn off Bluetooth and on and wait like 1 minute and then it will connect again. iOS 17.1.1 sucks. When is iOS 17.2 coming out? Well, I've already talked about that in the video. I have had a couple issues with AirPods Pro 2 as well. I think it's the AirPods update though, not iOS. Tama5153 says model 12 with 17.1.1. Occasional short freeze ups, typing or scrolling with iMessage. Battery life is fine for me. Thriving Branch says iOS 17.1.1 on iPhone 12. Battery has been better than previous 17 versions. Still seeing a number of bugs though. Most recently, issue with the sleep alarm toggle in the control panel showing as off when it was still enabled. The alarm scared me when it fired because it showed as off. Also, still have the issue with sleep in general not syncing between my watch and phone properly. Finally, AirPods connection seems to be worse again with this update. Sometimes when I ask Siri to initiate a call, it doesn't switch to AirPods sometimes, and the other person is left wondering why I can't hear them. Skateboarder 1000 says, battery on my iPhone 14 Pro has been really good. I can make it through a whole day. Stop charging at night and juice it up when I get ready for work in the morning. No complaints, and I'm on iOS 17.2 beta 3. Antonio Freitas 4347 says, hi, I'm using iPad 6th gen, and I have installed iPadOS 17.2 beta 3, and I noticed that it's running smoother and better, and battery is great, no fast drain, not lagging on the keyboard, and overall experience is very good. Better than the previous beta, iOS 17.2 beta 2. TTS292 says, I'm still running iOS 17.2 beta 3 on my iPhone 11 and still no bugs. I'm very excited for the next release and I can't wait for the public release, even though we probably won't see the public release until December or near the end of the month. Either way, I'm really looking forward to this, and I can't wait to see what Apple has next in store for us. Hope you're having a great Thanksgiving and your videos are awesome. Thank you. So that's everything with iOS 17.2 Beta 3 and iOS 17.1.1. Hopefully by this time next week, we'll actually have iOS 17.1.2 and iOS 17.2 Beta 4 with some new updates, bug fixes, and some different features or refinements. I hope we have some things as far as bug fixes, though. We really could use quite a few, especially with Wi-Fi and cellular. Let me know your experience in the comments below, and I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.